this technology, like any technology, has so much of potential in doing good.
So AI has become this generation-defining technology. And earlier, AI solutions were limited to laboratories. But then when people started using AI systems in very, very critical applications, where the human lives were going to be directly impacted, so people started thinking about, hey, what should be the right and responsible way to use AI in these kinds of domains? So for example, there was this bail tool called Compass that the US courts decided that they will use for deciding on bail applications. And so for black people, it was mispredicting the probability that they will commit a crime by overestimating it significantly. And there are other cases where hiring decisions were made by this kind of an automated tool. It stopped hiring women because the older system was hiring fewer women, and this kind of just amplified the effect. So the Center for Responsible AI, CeRAI, was set up in IIT Madras to study these issues.
Produce original evidence-based interdisciplinary research to inform how governments, policymakers, academics, researchers, technologists think about these issues from an India perspective. There are primarily three research tracks, questions of explainability, questions of safety, and the impact of AI on society.
Technical issues needed to be addressed. That's the first piece of the problem.
What this essentially means is being able to explain how artificial intelligence systems are making decisions about individuals and communities, but to be able to explain that in a language that is easily understandable by a common person. To be able to make people, communities, and entire nations more informed about how AI works and to not fear it.
The second piece of the problem was about regulations. Are existing regulations sufficient to take care of the complexities introduced by AI? To educate the students on how best to use these models and where are the safe places they can use it and what are the unsafe uses.
Spread the awareness that before, you know, deploying these things in our sectors, we should actually check for its readiness. So we call it deployability of the AI model.
Being a much more complex system, right? So it requires us to look at the end-to-end design cycle of AI. When you're talking about, you know, gathering data, right? What kind of modalities you can use for gathering data? So that's a different set of people you should get input from, people who understand what is happening on the ground. And then when you go and talk about what kind of algorithms to design, right? What kind of features to select, so on and so forth, then you need input from a different set of people and a different kind of input is needed from them. And the third piece is the impact of AI on society. What kind of new interactions between humans are enabled by using this AI system? Is there job displacement that is going to happen? What kind of new skills that people need to be trained on so that they can use these AI systems more effectively? We have tried to look at building a participatory design framework for AI systems, where we try to get all the stakeholders who would be affected by the deployment and the use of this technology and get their input into how the technology itself is framed. We also work with many of the government bodies now,
including the Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor, to think about what an AI governance framework for India looks like.
Apart from that, we have international collaboration that has been going on. So we work with universities in Australia in understanding responsibilities of AI in achieving net zero. And then we have partnered with the Responsible AI UK initiative to look at solutions that can work across cultures. Then we are interested in looking at biases in Indian language, toxic language or very gendered representations or stereotypes and so on and so forth, right? We don't understand that in Indian language to a whole extent.
Now people are saying lawyers will lose their jobs, doctors are going to lose their job, nurses are going to lose their job. But I don't think that is entirely true because as Nandan Nilekani mentioned a few years ago in the convocation at IIT Madras, we have to reskill. We have to reskill ourselves in ways that we can work with AI.
Simple things that differentiate humans from machines. And what is that? That's intuition, that's experience, that's empathy, that's a fundamental imagination and curiosity to understand the world. What machines do really well is analyze, interpret, summarize text. And perhaps what that means is humans need to think about all of the other tasks that humans continue to do well.
That means we have to create the ground for us. So that's what we are creating, a fertile ground for students. In 1 or 2 years or 3 years, you will see a huge change in terms of doing both tech as well as policy, healthcare sector, agriculture, climate change, finance, every aspect of life that AI is going to impact. Probably we can become more efficient, serve more people, more empowerment of women, marginalized, everybody.
And it is our responsibility to ensure that AI is being used responsibly. And that is one of the main purposes of this sector.